Chrome grills went out in the 80s. What was Subaru thinking, putting on a grill that looked more at home on a pickup truck? Luckily, they have the solution with the JDM Sports Grill. Here's the one part you're going to need. Order it online, $250. These are the tools you need, a couple of flathead screwdrivers and a stubby Phillips. Start by taking the push pins out of the top of the existing grill. You'll need your small flathead for this. Just pop the center pin up about 2-3 millimeters. Once it's up, grab the bottom of the pin and the whole thing pulls out. Don't make the mistake of trying to push the center up as far as it can go because you just jam the pin in there. Now that you've got those pins removed, the whole grill should be able to pop loose. This push pin is located at the top of the bumper bar in the wheel arch. Use your flathead screwdriver to push the center pin in and then it will pop out nicely. Then, very gently, pull the bumper bar out. Try not to bend the plastic because as soon as you bend the plastic, you're going to be damaging that paint and it will crack and flake. Best to do this on a warm day. Once you've done both sides, the entire grill will pop off and rock forward. Subaru's instructions say to remove the entire bumper, but it's not necessary. You just need enough room to get in there with the stubby screwdriver to remove the two Phillips heads on both sides of the grill and the three across the bottom. Then you undo the two snaps on the left and the right of the grill, and then there are three or four of them across the bottom. Undo those four, the grill pulls right out. Out with the old and in with the new. It's easiest to start with the new grill by lining up the corners. There are grooves carved into the bumper bar. Just line it up, slide it back, the bottom snaps will catch on it, and it'll stick right into place. And then just click in the left and the right side. Get your stubby screwdriver, put your Phillips head screws back in. It is really that easy. So do up your two left, two right, and three across the bottom of the middle, and this job is done. Snap that bumper bar back on. Make sure you put the push pin at the top of the bar in the wheel arch. Push the grill back. Push the push pins back in. And once again, make sure that the center pin is up about 2-3 millimeters, just so that the pin will slide nice into those holes. You might have to jiggle it around a little bit to get everything to line up. Push the grill back. Eyeball it and you'll see where the pin goes in. Real simple. Now you've got the push pins in, just snap the centers back down and you are literally finished.